Yeah, hey there, guys. It's fair to say that Kelly Ayotte supporters would love to have a reason to party tonight, especially since a tight primary election night spilled into the next day, as we know, basically robbing them of a chance to celebrate. As for the candidate herself, well, she's been doing what she's basically been doing for the last 18 months out there campaigning. She spent the day going to various polling locations. She actually cast her own ballot at Charlotte Avenue School, very happy to do so after a long campaign.
Good morning. How are you? It was quite an honor to cast the ballot. It's been a real privilege meeting people here in New Hampshire and campaigning over the last 16 months. And it was great to have my family here today. Couldn't do this without my family and their support.
Now, Kelly Ayotte's actually hitting one more campaign location, or polling location, rather, before she heads back to the hotel to watch the results start to come in. That's in Bow. Meanwhile, her staff and supporters have been here setting up for what they hope will be a big party tonight. And the only thing that will really stop that, most pundits believe, is a huge upset. And certainly that's what Paula Hodes' campaign would like to see tonight. For more on that side of the story, let's send it over to Gene Mackin, who's standing by live at his headquarters. Gene?
Josh, supporters expected to start trickling into Hodes headquarters in just about an hour. Paul Hodes voted and conquered this morning near the State House with his wife of 30 years, Pego, at his side. He shook supporters' hands, gave a few hugs, and his supporters actually followed him, signs in hand, as he entered the poll. The two-term Democratic congressman, now vying for a Senate seat, said no matter what happens today, he is certainly proud of his campaign.
I'm really proud of the campaign we've run. We've talked about the clear choice between going backwards to what's failed us or going forward and coming together. And I'm looking forward to going forward.
And Paul Hodes said he had a busy schedule today, visiting polling places and thanking his volunteers. Live in Concord, Gene Mackin, WMUR News 9.